My dad had been in World War II, and my uncles had been in the Korean War. And growing up here in South Carolina, very patriotic, there was a war going on, Vietnam, and I just assumed that when my time came, I would go. And so I joined the Navy. I went to Officer Candidate School in the worst blizzard in the history of New England. After a period of time there, I graduated, and my first assignment was the Mobile Riverine Force in country Vietnam up in the rivers.
I think probably the trait I admire most in Mike is loyalty. Loyalty to country, loyalty to his family and to his friends.
Often I was working in what the military would call a SCIF. It stands for Sensitive Compartmented Information Facility. So think of a ship and you're down inside the ship in a steel box. That was my life. After I was the intelligence officer for General Powell in the first Gulf War, Desert Shield and Desert Storm, I was selected to be the new director of NSA.
Michael is a thoughtful, long-term thinking kind of man, and believed in this idea so thoroughly as a way to protect our country from critical threats to our infrastructure and other such things. Michael's commitment to sort of earning followership, getting the folks to the point where not only do they think it's important to follow him because of maybe some organizational reason, he's the boss, but because of an inspirational reason. He wants the most from every one of us, and he'll spend the time to build that kind of a trust and followership that I think is the mark of an enduring and lasting leader.
Right after Desert Storm, actually, he was intelligence officer serving Cheney and Colin Powell, and the decision they made not going in and finishing the job in Iraq, and he came back and gave me the 10,000 foot view of why they did not go into Iraq.
I found leadership works best when you focus on those who are following to make sure they succeed. And if you conduct your affairs in a way that they succeed, good things happen to you.
Mike is mission focused. He is truly privileged to serve, and he lives his life that way, and he would never fail to answer the call. So I think that his willingness to serve the public, to earn and keep the public's trust, is remarkable.
As we get older, we have an opportunity to bring our experience to the table and to stay relevant, to have impact. And that's all, you know, it seems as you get older, it's very important. He's writing a book that I think will be a New York Times bestseller. He is one of the top cybersecurity experts in the world. And he also presently sits at the head table consulting for the NSA.
So I was there for 4 years. And at the end, not paying much attention, living my compartmented life, my staff was planning a spectacular retirement. So I'm sitting there and they're going through sort of a this is your life. And up on the screen pops General Colin Powell, who's my hero. And he said, Mike, I'm sorry I couldn't be there, but I just want to thank you for your service and your professionalism. Oh, that would really touch it. Then boom, it was the Secretary of Defense. And he made some similar comments, and I said, wow, this, you know, I had no idea. And then it was President H.W. Bush. I'd briefed him during the Gulf War, first Gulf War, and interacted with him. And he was a wonderful man. He was a real statesman in my view, and very strategic and very smart and very warm. And he just sort of leaned into the camera and said, Mike, we're going to miss you. Thank you for your service. We appreciate what you've done for the nation. And that's probably the proudest moment of my life.